स्विट्जरलैंड इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द टॉपिक जर्नल द टोटल कैरिड डाउन ऑफ द प्रीवियस पेज विच इज टू बी ब्रॉट डाउन ऑन दिस पेज इज रुपीज 23,50,800. It's clear. So here now yesterday we were dealing with the transactions related to the different transactions related to sales of the goods. It's clear. Now here we will start the sale of assets and investments. So 25th transaction is sold old furniture for rupees 20,000. Say this 25th transaction happened on 25th of January 2020. When we are selling the furniture, what is going to come? Cash is going to come. Cash account will be debited rupees 20,000. And what is going out? Old furniture is going out, but we will not write old or new. We will just write furniture. So two furniture account 20,000, being old furniture sold for rupees 20,000. And this term old will be mentioned in the narration as an explanation to this transaction. Now 26th transaction. Sold old machinery of rupees 1,50,000 to P. An old machine has been sold to P for rupees 1,50,000. Received from P rupees 40,000 in cash and a check of rupees 80,000 on account. On account means the rest will be received later on, and P's account will be maintained in the books of accounts. See working note 5. Machinery sold for rupees 1,50,000 less cash received 40,000 less check received 80,000. We will subtract them, total comes to 30,000. This is the amount yet to be received from P. So rupees 30,000 is yet to be received from P. So P becomes our debt. So cash account. Now see one more thing. 26th, this transaction was there. On 27th, deposited P's check into bank. So whenever a check is received and nothing is mentioned regarding its deposit in the bank, in the entire question, it will be assumed that the check was was deposited into the bank on the same date and the entry will be passed through bank account. But like in OAR, on 26th transaction means 26th of January, 27th transaction means 27th of January. On 26th, the check was received for rupees 80,000 from P, and on 27th, it is mentioned that deposited P's check into bank. In such case, the day when the check is received, it will be shown as check in hand account in the books of account, and the day it is deposited into bank account will be debited and check in hand will be credited. Now see over here. So we have sold old machinery to P for rupees 1,50,000 and received from P rupees 40,000 in cash. So cash is coming in, cash account debit 40,000 and a check of rupees 80,000, and this check is later on in the next transaction is given deposited P's check into bank on 27th. So is din check bank mein nahi jama hua. Agar isi din hi ho jata to direct likh dete bank account debit. Ya agar niche bhi kahin kuch nahi mention hota is P ke check ke bare mein, we would have assumed that the check was deposited on the same date in the bank. So here check in hand account will be debited rupees 80,000. P yet rupees 30,000 is to be received from P, so P will become our debtor for rupees 30,000. It's clear. So P's P account will be debited because our debtor is increasing, 30,000. Two machinery account, and what is going out? Machinery is going out of the worth of rupees 1,50,000, and 1,50,000 will be credited. Being old machinery sold to P for rupees 1,50,000, received cash rupees 40,000 and a check of rupees 80,000 on account from P. It's clear? Now on 27th, deposited P's check into bank. When the check was received from P, it was debited as check in hand account. Now this check is deposited into the bank. So bank is the receiver of the check. Bank account will be debited rupees 80,000 to check in hand account. And this check is going out of the firm. So when the check was received, check in hand was debited. When the check is going out to the bank, out of the firm and is going to the bank, check in hand account will be credited rupees 80,000. Being P's check deposited into bank. It's clear? So, whenever in any question it is given received a check from so and so, you will go through the entire question, whatever are the number of transactions given to you, you will go through those transactions and you will find out that whether that check was deposited into the bank on any of the future dates or not. And if it nothing is mentioned, then it will be assumed that the check was deposited into the bank that same day in which it was received. Now, next is sold investments for rupees 30,000. Now, we are selling investments for rupees 30,000. See, when the investments are purchased, at that time, bank account is credited. When the investments are sold, at that time also the transaction will be through bank. The money will be directly deposited into the bank as per the modern system of dealing in securities. That is, now everything is done online. So the money will be directly transferred to our bank account. So bank account debit 30,000 to investment account 30,000, being investment sold for rupees 30,000. It's clear? Now 29 transaction, bank deposited reported P's check to be dishonored. Bank ne intimate kiya ki P ka check ho gaya dishonored. When P's check has been dishonored, so P will become our debtor. Again, P will be debited, क्योंकि जब P से हमें चेक मिला तो हमने क्या किया था, हमने जो है उस चेक को मान लिया कि भाई चेक मिल गया 80,000 रुपया कम कर दिया और 30,000 से P को हमने अपना डेटर शुरू किया. बट नाउ P का जो चेक था वो हो गया क्या डिसऑनर, तो P दोबारा से हमारा डेटर बन गया फॉर रुपीज 80,000. एंड जो हमने बैंक में पैसा दिखाया था कि 80,000 रुपए बैंक में जमा हो गए, दैट मनी विल बी क्रेडिटेड, बैंक अकाउंट विल बी रिड्यूस्ड बाय रुपीस 80,000. सो बैंक अकाउंट इज द डेबिट बैलेंस, सो इट इज टू बी रिड्यूस्ड, देयरफॉर बैंक अकाउंट विल बी क्रेडिटेड. इट्स क्लियर टू? सो बीइंग पीस चेक रिपोर्टेड टू बी डिसऑनर्ड. इट्स क्लियर? सो दीज आर द ट्रांजेक्शंस.